That's 3, 2, 1. Hey everybody and welcome back to another house building. So I announced yesterday on Twitter that I'm starting a new building series. So hello, this is it. Today I am starting a top 10 down building series. So if you look to the title, you can already guess what this series is about. I am going from 10 down by squares to make the tiniest house that I'm possible to make. So today we are starting with a 10 by 10, and I hope that I will go as far as possible. So next week will be a 9 by 9, the week after 8 by 8, and so on. So yeah, I'm really excited for this. So this is the 10 by 10. This is going to be a modern retro kind of house, just very sleek inside, but the inside also has vibes of the 60s 70s, just a bit retro. I really love that style. And last week I also posted a lot of videos, not every one of them were voiced, especially not the monochromatic ones, because it's been very busy with university. But I wanted to kick off this video with a voiceover about the series. So I hope you're all doing very well. For me it's been especially busy with university, but I still had some time to do builds and to edit them. So I'm happy I was able to do that. And yeah, so you see that I do make use of the whole lot. I am especially excited for the inside of the house. So this is just the outside, which is a little bit lifted, so they can still sit and watch a bit of the outside of their house, because this house is located near the water. So if you want to look outside, you're still able to. First I was thinking of adding these fences, but it really didn't look great, so I just deleted that. And yeah, I am especially happy with, I guess, how the bedroom turned out. I think that and the living room are the two things in this house that I'm most excited for. It's really fun that I thought of firstly doing a kind of a old style meets new style, because with the windows you really do have the feeling that with the color scheme on the outside and the woods, that you think that you're an old house, especially when this house is built in Windenburg. But you know how people go live in an old house but completely renovated. So I wanted that feeling to really come through in this house. And I think in the end, it's not so much a renovation. Sure, the windows are different than an old style house. The floors are mostly hard, dark woods, and I don't necessarily think that it's renovated. They could easily just kept the old floorings and maybe just give them a little fix up. But as you can see, the theme of the house is black, white and red. I think you can see that by now, and I'm really, really in love with how that actually looks. Here I was really struggling with what to do next, because I didn't plan the easiest layout of the house. Because it's quite a big house, I could have done a lot more with rooms, but I didn't feel like it. I'm really happy that I didn't, because this is something that I would normally not go for, because this is quite a big house and I didn't add something like a study in. But there is a laptop in this house at the dining room, so you still have all the necessities if you want to play with this house. This house is always on the gallery. All my houses, by the way, are on the gallery, so if you see something fun, you can always just go to the gallery. Sorry, my gallery name is Howie Hamster, so you can always find that. Oh, and if you guys would like to follow me on Instagram, I used to really update it a lot. I didn't anymore because it really took a lot of time, because I didn't use any planners. But now I do, and it's a lot easier to post on Instagram. So Instagram is always more fun because it's a lot more visual. So if you have it and you would like it, you can join me on there. It's also just called Holly Hamster Official for that one. So yeah, I think those links are also down below, so you can check that out. So we're going to the bathroom, and I realized the bathroom is actually quite big, and I wanted to do something fun with that. So I used this bathtub. I regularly never use bathtubs in Sims house. I think when your Sims use it, it's really slow. I think that is why I never use it. And I also made use of those wooden shelves to create more of a larger washing table moment. I'm not sure. But yeah. It's currently Sunday morning. I'm recording this before tutoring kids. So it's really 8 a.m. in the morning. I'm so freaking tired. And off that, I also need to like study myself, so I'm not, don't know why I'm setting up this early, but I hope you have a lovely weekend, and will have, and not your whole weekend will be chopped full with all of university or school or whatever you're doing. I hope it's a bit more relaxed, I really do. But yeah, the items that I'm using, you can really see, are quite varied. But I did use some items of luxury. I don't know what the pack is, but I use more luxurious items. Like I use some things from Machino. I use some things of that luxury pack, and I use with this kitchen. I've never did a kitchen like this before. Like with, well, maybe I did once, but I didn't use two colors. I don't use two colors in the kitchen very often. I know some swimmers do, but regularly I wouldn't do that. And I'm really fun how it turned out, because this whole house is like these three colors. And now the kitchen also has that. And I really wanted to know, like, everyone else with that thing above the stove. I'm not sure what it's called. The first one, do you guys size that down? Because it's always too big for me. Yeah, maybe if you don't use any cabinets above the kitchen, I guess you would have space for it. But I always struggle, so I always tend to use this one. But yeah, it's almost the end of the video. It's just finishing up the kitchen and the dining area and the outside. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, let me know down in the comments below, or leave a thumbs or subscribe. Rather have the last one, because I'm really close to 275 subscribers, so I'm really happy with that. Follow me on Twitter, Instagram, the gallery, YouTube, maybe, if you have the time and you enjoy my videos. And stay tuned for the rest of the 10x10 top-down building series. I'm looking forward for how far I can get. So, have a nice weekend. Have an awesome week. Stay safe. Stay tuned for more. And I will catch you guys in the next video. Bye guys. Love you.